Hi friends, welcome back to Free Automation Learning Channel and my name is Chirag. Today we are going to discuss a new topic, that is how we can handle autocomplete drop down. So basically we found that when we are automating our Android APK file and there would be some autocomplete drop down where we have to write any letter and then the suggestion would come by the application. So how we can automate those drop down boxes. So I'm going to discuss in this video, and to automate that scenario we need to use a new method that is known as press key code. So I'm using this method and I would discuss about this, and there would be some keys which we need to use. These keys are Android key code. So we are also discuss about what is Android key code, what is the use of it, what is press key code method. So now you know, I am just going to show you what is the autocomplete drop down box. So this would be my emulator, and here is a country where I write IN. So you can see this would be a autocomplete, means some suggestion has been come from our application, and I need to select India, so I have to click on India, right? So how we can automate this drop down boxes? Let me show you the automator UI. I am creating a snapshot, and if you can see that there would be no, let me just expand in such a way that you guys should watch the element what I'm talking. So you can see that we are not able to identify this British Indian or India. We are just able to identify this last give button. You can see that give me focus is the last element, a mobile element, which are able to identify by UI Automator Viewer. We are not able to identify this India, the value of India and the mobile element of this India. How we can handle such type of scenario? So I'm just going to discuss this thing in this video, how we can identify this scenario, this type of scenario where we are not able to identify the mobile element by using this autocomplete box, right? So this is our theory part. Let me discuss what would be our scenario. We are using a same application which we are using to automate our test scripts. Here I would click on views, after that I tap on autocomplete, and I would tap screen top, and here I would write India, and then I would have to select India. As you can see, there is no mobile element present under UI Automator. So we need to automate this, and we need to identify any workaround how we can handle this, such type of scenarios, right? So let me open my Eclipse and we will write our code. As this is our tutorial 18, so I am going to create a new tutorial class that would name is 18. And click on finish. So here I'm going to use Android driver and will pass mobile element and give the name of driver. Now I'm going to create a new method for setup. And here I will give desired capabilities. And give our basic capabilities which we need to invoke our session. So here I am using mobile capability types. We can also give the capabilities by using this mobile capability types. First is our platform name. So I would give my platform name as Android, as I am automating this app on Android platform. After that, I have to give another capabilities. And its name would be device name. So I have to pass my device name. I'm using Nexus 9. And here I would to pass new capabilities. And its name would be app. So I give my path of my application where I have keep my testing application. So by this way we can identify the path of our directory. Now after that I have to go app and let me copy this application name and paste here. So these three capabilities I need to invoke my EPM server. Now I have to initialize my driver. My driver would be Android driver. After that, new URL. As I am running my APM server on this host, so I need to give this. After that, driver, web driver, and hub I need to pass. And here I need to pass cap. Now just import URL. It will fire our exception, so throws exception. For that, here I need to use mobile element, right? And here I need to give driver dot manage dot timeout dot implicit wait for 20 seconds. So guys, this is the common code which we use in every tutorial. So hope you understand this code. Now I am going to create a new method which is handle autocomplete. First I need to click on driver dot here. I need to click, and what would be the, let me identify the X mobile element, right? So I have to click on view. I have to take the snapshot of this current screen where I need to identify mobile element. I need to identify mobile element of view. So I need to give views here. After typing views, again I have to take a snapshot of the current screen, I have to click on autocomplete. So let me write the code of to clicking on this autocomplete. After tapping autocomplete, I need to click on first screen top. So let me also handle this. And after this, I have to take the mobile element of this screen where I have to write. So I would take ID here, driver dot find my ID, and send keys would be India. Right. So here I have to write India. Now I have to click on India, right? So how can I click? If I take the snapshot of the current screen, I can see that I am not able to see any mobile element regarding India. So how can I select India by using this? So you can see, if I press down key from my keyboard, I can able to get downwards, right? You can see now I'm in British Indian Ocean, and if I click on down keywords on my keyboard, so I have to go to Dow or India, right? So in this way just click on India. So how we can handle these things on our test scripts? So there would be a method which is provided by our Android driver, that would be a press keyword. If you can see, you can see this press keyword key code. By using this, we can able to handle such scenario. But it would do, it will do the things. If you can see here, I have to find Android key code. So there are different key code are present. By this we can use. Sometimes we are not able to handle the method which is provided by APM or Android driver. So we are able to handle this such scenario by using this key code. So here I'm using the workaround by using this key code, and if you can see, I have to take the page down button. So I am go to and click a page down end, right? So by using this, what it will do, suppose it have focus on here, it put me a one down end, right? So this way we can. Now again I have to select ending because I have to select India. Now I have to click on enter. So I have to click on this. By this way we are able to get the we are able to select that India in our drop down, right? So let me select India over here and take the snapshot again. So I'm able to verify whether I'm able to identify this India or not. Again here I have get the code of India. If after selecting India, whether my text is present or not, I have to check this. So here I'm getting the text of that field by using get text method, and let me print the string. Right, if text is equals to SYSO passed as field, and what would be my text? My text would be this India, so I need to copy this text and pass over here, right? So let me give some slip here, hard-coded slip, so that you guys could see what would be the happening when this script would run, right? So let me give a 2 seconds for every step, so you can see understand what I'm doing here and what would be the code doing here, right? So let me run this code. Before running, I need to create a new method for the teardown driver. Here I need to create an object of current class, so I'm able to call those method which I created earlier in this tutorial, obj dot handle autocomplete and obj dot teardown. So let me throw those exception first, and this would be a interpreted exception. So my code has been almost done. Now we will see what would be the output. So guys, hope you can understand these things, and I will discuss this after running this code. As I run this code and my APM server has been launched, yes, it is working. So soon this application has been launched and we will see what would be the output, right? You can see the it click on view, it click on autocomplete, it click on screen top. Now it is writing the code that is India. Now to second pause, it goes to first, it goes to second. Now it will click enter, and after that it has been passed. So you can see that the result would be India found and has been completed passed, right? So this is the code which we are looking to handle these things. So you can see that by using this method we are able to identify, or we are able to do those things which are we are not able to identify by XPath, right? Or we are not able to identify mobile element of autocomplete drop down box. So by using this approach we are able to handle those scenarios. So this is the code, and hopefully you like this video and hopefully you understand why we are using this. This would be a workaround where I am not able to find India mobile element or any other drop down value mobile element. So by using this key code press down, we are able to do the page key code page down, and again we have to do such things. So again I write this code and then I have to enter, so I write the enter code. So guys, hopefully you understand these things, and thank you for watching this video. I will come with a new video soon, and thank you. Bye bye. Take care.